Greinke hit Carlos Quentin, and he didn't rush at first. He started talking, so, and then he goes, and by that time, and then you see me pop in right about now.
Welcome back, everyone, to Paris Perfect. Today, we're doing our first reaction video with some of the best moments in Adrian's career in Major League Baseball. So, got a little whiskey, gonna walk down memory lane.
Let's do it.
So, the first clip, I know is gonna be memorable, right? It's your first Major League home run.
2-2 on the way, and Gonzalez bolts one to right. Get out of here, ball! Gone!
Buried that one deep.
Skinny guy.
Skinny guy. Playing for the Rangers.
It was actually a home run in a back-to-back-to-back home runs that we hit that game. And that was, I was the third part of the back-to-back-to-back. So there was a back-to-back going into my
A lot of pressure.
And a lot of pressure. And somehow the pitcher was just serving them up. One of the first big moments of my career.
Oh, I can imagine. So the second one we have is your very first at-bat as a Dodger.
Adrian is wearing the old number he wore in San Diego. He drives one into deep right field, right down the line in the corner. Three-run home run.
Three-run home run?
I always like to tell people, the one thing that sticks out for me that game is that I hit a home run my first at bat, but then I struck out my next three at bats. So it was a lot of fun. We had a day where we were traded that day from Boston to LA, got on the plane in the morning after we went to the clubhouse to pack up all our stuff, got on the plane, flew to LA, landed in LA about 2 hours before the game started.
Jeez.
Got in the car from the airport, drove straight to the ballpark. Got to the ballpark probably an hour before the game started. I literally went in the clubhouse. They gave us all the uniforms, everything. And I mean, it was so hectic trying to get ready for the game that by the time the first at bat happened, I was still kind of like in that whirlwind, like, I don't know what's going on. Happened to catch a fastball, keep it fair, hit a three-run homer. We won the game, but like I said, it was so hectic. The rest of the game was a blur, and I struck out the three times. So. But it was, I mean, another, like, that was just an amazing, memorable moment for sure.
Yeah. So the next clip that we have is a pretty important game. Game one, NLCS in 2016. And you had so many amazing plays in that game. I think we're just gonna run through the beauty of game one.
All right, let's do it.
NLCS 2016.
That's into center field, a base hit. One run scores. Fowler can't make the play. This game is tied. Gonzalez delivers.
Can go on tears where he is an RBI machine. This one hit in the air to left center field. It is gone.
So this was actually game one and game two. We ended up losing game one. In the bottom of the eighth, they hit a home run, and then we lost it in the ninth. But the next game, the home run we see is a home run that I was able to hit, and we won game two. It took us to, you know, what it was, a long series that we ended up losing the series to the Cubs, but it was definitely some big moments there.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah. How does it feel when you get up in those clutch situations and you deliver?
It's great. I mean, there are so many moments that are not on any highlights that I did not deliver. They might be on somebody else's highlights. But it's obviously, you know, very gratifying, you know, to be able to come up big for the team and put the team in a position to win games, and especially in the playoffs. So those are moments that I definitely will never forget.
So next, I thought you made so many different error-saving plays throughout your career. We've got a compilation. This will probably be fun to see.
Yeah, one of the things I really enjoyed or really took pride in was, you know, saving and playing a really good first base as good as I could do. You know, being a first baseman, you can help out your teammates so much that when they make tough throws or bad throws, you have to be ready. And that was something I really enjoyed. And there was definitely some plays and some throws that I was able to, you know, pick balls out of the dirt, jump, you know, move around the bag jumping. And, you know, I was always somebody that took a lot of pride in playing first base, you know. So for me, it was very, very important. I always told my infielders, like, just throw it. I'll do my best to stay in the bag and catch those throws. This throw from Justin here off the line, you know, I have to switch to the backside. These are throws that are off, like, right there. I'm trying to get back, and I just get back to the line. Yeah, those are always fun.
So the next one that we have is a bench clearing incident in April 13th of 2013. And these don't happen very often, and I've always wondered, like, what is going through your mind? So let's check it out, and I'll ask you a reaction on the backside.
So yeah, I remember this, Greinke hit Carlos Quentin, and he didn't rush at first. He started talking, so, and then he goes, and by that time, and then you see me pop in right about now.
Now.
And so I fall, but then I go in there and I pull some players out of the way. And you can see me back here pulling.
Yeah.
I'm back there pulling somebody, making sure, and then I'm going back in, and then I'm grabbing. The main thing here is like, no cheap punches, right? I mean, that's the thing. It's like nobody hitting somebody from the back or throwing in some cheap punches on people in the dirt.
Weird, right? Because you've played for the Dodgers and the Padres, so. Yeah.
And this is 2013. I had just played for the Padres in 2010. So this is like, I had a lot of teammates on the Padres as well. And yeah, I mean, it's really like just making sure that nobody's, throwing some cheap punches in there. So I always thought that these bench clearing brawls were just the weirdest way to retaliate if somebody had a beef against you. Because you rush the mound and you might get one punch in before the rest of the team takes you down. And right. Now you're at the bottom of the pile getting punched. So I saw that happen too many times where I was like, that's not the smartest thing to do. And it was always the hitter that got hit by the ball that got suspended afterwards for rushing the pitcher.
Right. So it's a lose-lose.
It's a lose-lose, exactly. It wasn't really a rivalry between the Padres and the Dodgers. This one happened to be a rivalry between Zach Greinke and Carlos Quentin that went back to when Zach was in Kansas City, Quentin was in White Sox in Chicago, and apparently Greinke had beaten them a couple times for I don't know what reason, but this was probably like the fourth or fifth time he had beaten them, and so at that point he was kind of fed up with the fact that Greinke kept beating
him. You're beaming
me. I never had that like that picturesque thing that you dream about, down by three, grand slam, bottom of the ninth, all that stuff. But I was able to hit some walk-off home runs, walk-off grand slam, walk-off hits, and so those were, close enough, I guess.
Yeah, but that's amazing though, the walk-off win, under your performance. That's pretty cool.
Yeah, those are fun. Those are a lot of fun. When you get to celebrate at home plate, those are fun.
Thank you for joining us for our first reaction video.
These were definitely some clips that that stick out in my career, and it was a lot of fun. Thank you. That's great. I hope you guys enjoyed it as well. We'll see you guys next time.
Change up. A drive out to deep center field.